Let's compute the price of a stock. How much would you pay today for a stock that will pay a dividend of DIV1 next year and will have a price of P1 next year? Let's assume that you buy the stock today and sell it next year after receiving the dividend. The cash flow you receive next year is the sum of DIV1 and P1, that is the dividend plus the price you get from the sale. To figure out the price you should pay today, you discount this amount as shown in this formula. Note that DIV1 and P1 are not certain. You should enter here what investors expect today, these quantities to be in the future. Also, the R sub E is called the opportunity cost of equity capital, or simply the cost of equity. As we have learned, the discount rate we use is the rate of return that can be earned on other investments that are as risky as the stock we are considering. While this formula is correct, it is difficult to apply as it requires knowledge of P1, the price of the stock next year. If we do not know the price of the stock today, how are we supposed to know the price of the stock next year? Well then, let's find the price of the stock next year. To do this, assume you buy the stock in year 1, earn dividend DIV2 in year 2, and sell the stock in year 2 for, say, P2. The formula for the price of the stock in year 1 is given here. We can now plug the formula for P1 into the formula for P0 to obtain the following. Now, we no longer have P1, but we have a similar problem as we do not know the price of the stock in year 2, or P2. So we do a similar trick and express P2 as the present value of the dividend in year 3 plus the price in year 3 and replace it in the expression for P0 to obtain the following. I hope you can start to see a pattern here. If we keep going for T periods, we will find that the price of the stock today is given by this formula. If T is very large or infinity, the last term would be essentially zero, and the expression for the price of the stock would be this one. In other words, the stock price is the present value of all future dividends.